Hi, I'm Morgan, and welcome to this tutorial. Do you need to replace your crankset because you want to switch things up? No worries, we'll show you how. For this, you're going to need about 45 minutes of your time. It's pretty easy, and you won't need any help. Tool-wise, you're going to need a 5, 6, and 8 millimeter Allen keys and a crank removal tool. First thing you want to do is loosen the two pinch bolts on the arm with the 5mm Allen key. When they're out, grab your crank remover, place it on the end cap, and then turn counterclockwise. Then, you want to lift the stub plate with a flat screwdriver. If you don't do this, you won't be able to remove the arm. Once the stub plate is out of the way, you can pull the left arm off the spindle by hand to remove it completely. Then, you're going to go to the other side of the bike to release the chain to facilitate the extraction. Now, to remove the crank, you want to tap on the spindle to help it come out. Put the chain out of the way and remove the crank entirely. Now that it's out, you can take the crankset apart. Here, what you want to do is unscrew the four bolts. So, now grab the arm and move it through the big ring. Put it down, and then you can put the small ring on top and put the bolts back in place. When you feel some resistance, you can stop tightening. Alright, now that the rings are back together with the arm, it's time to reassemble everything. First, you're gonna wanna clean the grease surplus on the frame of the bike on both sides. Then, grab your crankset and apply grease on the surface of the spindle. After this, grab the chain to properly place the spindle. Tap on the crank, put the chain on the small ring, and then push it in place. Make sure it's in contact with the frame. Now, it's time to put the arm back in place. What you should do here is spot the markings on the spindle and the arm itself. If you do that, the arm should snap in place straight away. Then you want to grab the crank cap, place it in its original spot, and tighten it by hand at first, and then with the crank removal tool. You need to turn clockwise this time. Don't tighten too hard here. You can stop when you feel some resistance. Then, you can push down on the stop plate and make sure it's fully engaged. Once this is done, you can tighten the 2-pinch bolts with the 5mm Allen key. Now careful here. Don't over-tighten the first bolt straight away. Tighten it just enough, then do the other one, and go back to the first one to secure it, and then secure the second one. So, it was pretty easy, right? Now, if you don't feel confident doing this yourself, don't hesitate to come to the shop. Thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next one.